Now, let's discuss energy method to find frequency of SHM. In our early sections of the topic, we have studied that by calculation of restoring force and acceleration, we find the oscillation frequency and time period of SHM. There is another way to find out the same as using the energy of oscillations. Let's first write down the steps, how the method is applied, and then we'll have some examples and applications to understand it. This method is applied in three steps. And here step one is finding equilibrium position by balancing forces or torques acting on body. If body is under translational SHM, then we balance forces, and if the body is under angular SHM, along with its rotational motion, we balance torques to find out the stable equilibrium position of body. And next step, we oscillate the particle or body and at an intermediate instant, at an intermediate position of body, which should neither be at mean or at extreme position in between, we write total energy of system with the zero reference potential energy at mean position. When the body is oscillating, we consider zero reference potential energy at mean position, or even if minimum value is given, we can take minimum, but in most of the cases, no energy is given to us. So, we take zero reference potential energy at mean position and we write down the total energy of system at an intermediate position. This position must be at a displacement y from mean position, because it, as I told you, it should neither be mean or nor be extreme position. Now, after writing the total energy, as we know that total energy of SHM always remains constant, it only interconverts between kinetic and potential. So, in step 3, we differentiate the equation of total energy and equate it to 0. Because as total energy is constant, so its derivative with respect to time, you can also write differentiate with respect to time. Total energy never changes with time unless it is a damped oscillation. Here we are talking about SHM. So for an ideal situation, we ignore all losses. So we differentiate with respect to time the equation of total energy and equate it to 0. As soon as you differentiate and equate it to 0, this will result the basic differential equation of SHM, and from which we'll be able to calculate the value of angular frequency. This is the way how we analyze. Just now we have written it in a text form. Now let's take up some basic illustration to understand these steps, and then we'll take up some numerical examples also. Let's analyze a spring block pendulum by using energy method. Say we are given with a spring block pendulum in its equilibrium position. The block is of mass m and the spring is of constant k. And say this is the equilibrium position. We can state in equilibrium position the spring will be elongated by a distance y naught. So, at equilibrium position, its weight will be balanced by the force of a spring, that is ky naught. So, we can write mg is equals to ky naught as the equilibrium equation. Now, if we further displace the body and release it, it will start oscillating. And during oscillation, say we consider the body at an intermediate position, where it is at a further displacement y from mean position, below the mean position, and say it is moving up with a speed v. In this situation, if we write the total energy of a system, one block is at position y, as shown. We just write down the total energy. We can directly write the kinetic energy of block in this situation would be half mv square. If we find out the potential energy, it's gravitational, zero reference we'll take at the equilibrium position, so it is y distance below. So, because of gravity, we can say its potential energy would be minus mgy as it is below the reference position, or it can also be regarded as the work done by gravity due to which its potential energy is decreased as it is below the equilibrium position. If we would have taken it above the equilibrium position, then we would have taken plus mgy. Now, there is a potential energy stored in the spring also. If we talk about its overall extension, it will be y naught plus y. So, energy stored in the spring will be half k y naught plus y whole square. So, this is the total energy of oscillation of the system. We just differentiate it with respect to time. This will be dE by dt. Here half m is a constant v square. When we differentiate it, it will be half m 2v dV by dt minus mgy. The displacement can be differentiated as dy by dt plus half k. When we differentiate y naught plus y whole square, it will be twice of y naught plus y into dy by dt, and this should be equated to 0 because total energy does not vary with the time. In this expression, if we just have a look carefully, this 2 gets cancelled out, and if we just write it once again, first term dv by dt can be written as acceleration of mass, so it can be written as mva minus mg dy by dt can be written as its speed plus k y naught plus y, and dy by dt can again be written as v. This should be equal to 0. Here in this expression, v will also get cancelled out throughout the term, and it can be rewritten as ma minus mg plus k y naught plus k y is equal to 0. Here mg and k y naught also gets cancelled out, as we have already obtained the equilibrium equation. And on just rearranging these terms, we can say a plus k by m y is equals to 0, which can be written as a plus omega square y is equals to 0, or a can be written as minus omega square by y. So, on comparing these equation, we get omega is equals to root of k by m. This is the way how we can directly get the angular frequency of this oscillation. And this is the same angular frequency which we obtained by analyzing the restoring force acting on the block at a displacement from mean position.